Here in Rochester, January is a good month to talk about controlling humidity in a printed circuit board assembly area. Here we have to balance two opposing goals. The first is keeping components dry enough, because moisture in the air will permeate the plastic housing of any SMT component. And then during solder reflow, when the parts are heated quickly to 500 degrees Fahrenheit, any moisture trapped inside the package will expand rapidly. This is not such a problem for most larger components, but moisture-sensitive devices can suffer internal damage or even burst open. So they need to be stored at low humidity until they're soldered. This dry cabinet maintains 0.1% humidity and offers convenient dry storage for reels and tubes of parts that we use frequently, keeping them dry whenever they're not on the SMT line. For longer-term storage, we can also use special bags that are vacuum-sealed with desiccant and a moisture indicator inside. Moisture-sensitive devices have a limited number of total hours they can be out of dry storage before soldering, and this number depends in part on the humidity and temperature of the ambient environment they're exposed to. So you might think the drier the better for the assembly environment, but drier air means more static electricity and a higher risk of damage to components and assemblies from electrostatic discharge, or ESD. We take a lot of measures to control ESD, and one of them is maintaining the right level of humidity in the air. If the air is too humid, it will shorten the life of our moisture-sensitive devices. If the air is too dry, it will increase the risk of ESD damage. The IPC standard is 30% to 70%. Here in western New York, where the winter air is quite dry, we need to use a humidity control system. A good, safe, quality work environment has plenty of exhaust systems, and therefore a steady supply of fresh air coming in. This cold, fresh air needs to be heated and constantly humidified to maintain the IPC recommended range. Some manufacturers skip this expense and just rely on heel and wrist straps, but that's not best practice. In the summer, when there's too much humidity outside, we can rely on our normal air conditioning system to maintain the optimum range for both temperature and humidity. Check out our earlier videos for more details about moisture-sensitive devices and controlling ESD. Or contact us to learn more.